These are my latest thrift store finds, or I should say Bric-a-brac store finds, because they have these tags here that say B&B. I always thought these stand for bed and bath, which doesn't make much sense, but doesn't make sense either for a CD player to be categorized as furniture. But this time they actually spelled it out on the receipt. So apparently B&B stands for Bric-a-brac. Got these cassettes here, nothing special until I saw this Sony EF. I never seen any EF tapes by Sony, because we always got their HF tapes. And this one says excellent fidelity, so it's a little bit dubious if that's lower than HF or if it's about the same. Either way, it's a standard Type 1 tape. And I saw this one on the shelf and I was first excited because I saw metal and I was like, wow, it's a metal cassette. And I looked closer, it says Digital 8 compatible. So it's actually a Hi8 video cassette bundled together with regular audio cassettes here. But either way, it's still useful to me. I can use it with my Hi8 or Digital 8 camcorders. Got a couple CDs here, including the original Top Gun soundtrack, original 1986 release. And here is the CD player that I got. It's a cute little Aiwa. I actually saw this same model at the same store about a year ago, but that one didn't work and it was more expensive. This one seems to work fine and it was only $6.99. It is an Aiwa DX-N3. Very basic. It does have a remote sensor, but I didn't get the remote with it. Nice little amber backlit LCD on the front there. Obviously was designed to go with some kind of bookshelf system, but thankfully it just has a standard AC plug and RCA jacks on the back, so you can use it as a standalone CD player as well. Dated October 1991. Has some kind of CD control thing there. And it was made in Singapore. As a voltage selector. And otherwise, that's about it. For size comparison, there it is on top of my 1990 Sansui CD player. So, obviously, quite a bit smaller than a full-sized CD player. So now we can pop in our CD. A little bit slow opening there. One strange thing is that unlike most CD players, you can't just hit play to close the door and automatically start playing. You have to close it first, and then you can hit play. And there it goes, playing. Now you only get one set of buttons here for forwards and backwards. So by default, they're track buttons, but if you hit CD mode, it switches into search mode, and these become fast forward or fast reverse buttons. Also has a repeat function and some kind of memory set function. It says 20 random program access. So, nothing fancy. But not bad for $6. So, let's test it out with some music from Top Gun.
Taking you to touch and go.
Now I'm wondering if this thing can play CD-RW discs, so I just burned one using my ThinkPad here. And I didn't notice on the box this is up to 12x, because these are old discs from 2007. So I had it set to maximum speed, which I think is 24x. But I tried it out in my car and it played fine, so we'll see if it plays in this thing. Alright, let's see if it reads the track information. That just popped it up again, so I don't think that's a good sign. Nope, it's just popping it back out again. That's funny. Well, I'm going to try reburning it at 12x speed and see if that works. It's fresh out of the CD drive here, and I just burned it at 12x. So let's see if this works this time. Nope, it just pops it back out. So, pretty conclusive proof that this does not play CD-RWs. This time I burned just a regular CD-R disc, so it should work. I just want to make sure here. So let's see. It's spinning up, that's good. Took a while, but they finally recognized the track information. Well, it tries to play, but after it hit play, it just makes some noises, and then after a few seconds, it goes back to all zeros. See? So, for some reason, it cannot play CD-Rs. Unless maybe the lens is dirty. Well, here's a CD-R that I got at the thrift store a while back. Somebody went through the trouble of making a nice cover for it and a track listing, but they got some of the titles and artists wrong. In fact, quite a few, which I had to correct in my own handwriting there. So, let's see if this one works. Come on. Don't be so picky. See, that time it worked. So this thing must either have a dirty lens or a weak laser on it. There, it looks like it's playing, so let's see what it sounds like.
Hooray for a child that makes it through.
Heard that one in a while. You can hear it worked, but it sounded like a scratchy old LP because the error correction of the CD player was trying very hard to make up for lost data. So obviously the laser was having some trouble reading the disc. So in this case it worked, but it was just barely able to play it. And on other discs it was not able to play it at all. Or it would read the track information, but it wouldn't actually play the songs. There it is with the cover taken off. I cleaned the lens, so I'll see if that makes any difference. And circuitry is rather compact, but not nearly as much as the newer CD players from the late 90s and 2000s. I looked up some of the specs for these chips, and these two are controller chips for the CD player mechanism. This one is an op amp, which makes me wonder if this has an analog filter or a digital filter. And then over here is obviously the power supply with the filter cap. And that big chip is probably the controller for the remote control circuitry for hooking up to the rest of the stereo system that this originally came with. There's some blank spots there for inductors, which makes me wonder if that's where an analog filter would have gone on the output. And the funny thing is, you can see some wire jumpers there with a screw running right through them. So I don't know if that's a mistake or if that's supposed to be the way it's supposed to be. That just looks strange. There are two trim pots on this board. One says T-BAL and this one over here says F-BAL. So I believe this one is for tracking and this one is for focus. After cleaning the lens, I was able to get it to play that CDR that I recorded my laptop, but the sound is very, very scratchy. So it's clearly having quite a bit of trouble playing this disc. Can't.